Someplace the Ducks haven't been in 17 days. A six-game road trip, and that collective gasp you heard 2 nights ago from San Jose on Thursday was when John Gibson did not come out for the bell in the second period. But lo and behold, he's starting his game here tonight. By Ekman-Larsson. And then Archibald knocked down behind the net, loses possession. And the Ducks away. Here's Kasha. Lobbed ahead by Richie. He's in. Backhand. Score! Andre Kasha! Just 46 seconds into the game, the Ducks had spent the first 40 defending in their own end.
You know what? They showed some good patience. Little fake, goes to the backhand. That's one of his favorite moves against the youngster, Aiden Hill. And he just flips it up into the top corner. But what a pass by Nick Ritchie to Andre Kasha.
Ends the draw. Mahura slides it across. Sprong gets it to the net. Goal! On the deflection, I think Richie got a piece of it. It went off the far post and came back out behind Hill. Sprong in the slot, he scores! He hammered it on a great no-look pass.
That's Sprong, and we've talked about how well Daniel Sprong can shoot the puck, and I'm telling you, he got all of that one, and there was just no chance whatsoever for Aiden Hill.
Now it's Galchenyuk. Goligoski winds, no traffic in front that he liked. Hands it back over. Garland's wrist shot gloved off by John Gibson.
And spot the release. Look at Fisher, 36 in white, trying to take the eyes of the goaltender away, but Gibson tracks it all the way.
Hands it off. Ekman-Larsson goes down low. First penalty to Getzloff is over. Now it's a one-man advantage, and finally, they get the shot. And Galchenyuk sets up Ekman-Larsson for the power play goal.
Now this shot, unlike the first few one-timers from Galchenyuk, is inside the dots, and that's the key for Ekman-Larsson. You get a better shooting angle, left-handed shot, so he's well inside of the dot as he hits this one, and the shot is perfect.
Brian, 8 saves on 9 shots for John Gibson. The question this morning, as the day began, was whether or not he would be able to play. How'd he look to you in that first period? Well, here's a turnover, and Henrique makes it 3-1 as Nick Ritchie did the work and served up another primary assist.
A beautiful pass. Ekman-Larsson gets caught on a pinch. And kind of right here is where the puck gets fumbled. Look at that pass by Nick Ritchie. That was a gift. Absolute gift. And Cousins had turned it over, and Richie to Henrique, and once again, first shot of the period. I don't think Henrique touches that puck, which means that Nick Richie was able to tag up, get on the right side of the blue line before going back in to pressure the puck.
After the coach's challenges, determined the play was onside, therefore we have a good goal.
Now to Sprong, rim of the right circle, and right on the doorstep. Great pass by Richie, and it just went right through Silverberg. Sprong's pass back to the line. Didn't have a lot on it. Lindholm got it through, and it's in the glove of Hill.
Well, Nick Ritchie is becoming the master of the back pass.
And now Schmaltz intercepts into the Anaheim zone, caught on the back check by Sherwood. Curls away. Keeper trying to stay with him, throws it towards the net. Mosh pit in front of Gibson, who's got it underneath his pads.
Yeah, John Gibson looked a little uncomfortable. He was falling backwards. So much of goaltending is getting a read, anticipating where the passes are going, and you can get there ahead of time. Look out.
Oh, Labushkin's dump pin goes off of Gibson and right to the slot. The Coyotes cash it in. Christian Fisher, the first one there, and it's 3-2.
I mean, that right shoulder has got to be closed in comparison to his left. It's not. It was open. It hits his leg pad. Bounces right out to Fisher, and that is a gift for the Coyotes. Agliano there, because he left the front of the net, and if he had hung around the front of that goal crease, he would have had a tap in.
Lindholm floats it towards the net, deflected in by Nick Ritchie. Ritchie got a piece of it out high. I can't think Hill saw it, because Kasha, amongst others, was parked in front.
I think Ritchie gets a touch on it. Bennett hits the leg of Andre Kasha and bounces into the back of the net. And that's something that Anaheim has not had a lot of recently, John, and that is good bounces. to see Daniel Sprong just shoot that puck a hair quicker, John, a little better shooting angle.
Larson turns it over, and the Coyotes get it right back as Cousins completes a pass from Kraus. Larson fanned on the puck back in his own zone, and what looked like an innocuous play turned into a grade A scoring chance very quickly.
Yeah, good conversion, though, accepting the pass and a quick little flip up into the top corner over the left hand of Gibson. Been an eventful game for Cousins.
Runs into a teammate, now tries to shovel it away, but Ekman Larson comes up with it and floats it back to the net. Traffic in front of Gibson making things difficult. Here's Schmaltz. All the way out. Chychrun rips it home! Jacob Chychrun with his first career even strength goal. And we got a brand new hockey game.
And this is a cannon. Much like Daniel Sprong's goal, Chychrun just steps into that one and he rips it up into the top corner.
Nearly halfway through what has been thus far a scoreless third period. But 10 years ago, they would have blown the whistle 10 minutes ago. Connaughton behind the net moves it along. Now turn over. Here's Lindholm. What a save, Aiden Hill!
What a stop. What a stop by Aiden Hill. Great anticipation by Lindholm. He steps into the middle of the ice, grabs his puck.
Supports the puck there and gives it back to Kessler, who's tripped up by Chychrun. Around the boards it comes. Lindholm sweeps it across. Montour through traffic. Hill can't find it. It was in the skates of Richie.
I don't know if that puck got through to the goaltender or not, but big rebound. Goligoski able to tie up the stick of Nick Richie so he could not get a clean swat at it.
But the Coyotes defending down to 7:45 to go, third period. This one bounces away and Hinostroza pulls up. That hit the post. He went short side on Gibson and the Ducks are living right.
And it deflects off the post and out. So first big break of this third period belongs to John Gibson in Anaheim.
For a goal, a 3-0 loss to the Sabres. Well, they got four goals here tonight. Lindholm converged upon Fisher, trying to stump it, gets a bit away on the rebound, still loose, and it's kept out. Garland was there digging as well.
What a battle. That was a battle for John Gibson. Fisher gets three cracks at it, and somehow John Gibson shows some great leg strength there by keeping that pad in front of the goal line.
Now gives it to Rowney in the middle. He pops it up. Here's Stepan. Save Gibson, and he makes a save on the rebound as well. Here's Chychrun in a diving effort to block it, made by Carter Rowney.
There's no way that Hampus Lindholm was going to let him pass that puck to Clayton Keller. It was Stepan on the goaltender. And John Gibson manages to win the race to get those pads down to the ice.
He and Lindholm out to finish the game, and they're going to pass the puck, bringing us to overtime. For the 13th time this season, Anaheim will go beyond regulation. Gets it to Henrique, knocked off his stick though by Ekman Larson. He's got a lane and he sends it ahead. Here's Clayton Keller, 2-on-1 with Schmaltz. Keller over to Schmaltz, game over. Arizona wins 5-4 in overtime.
What a play, what a pass. This is an elite play. And the key is the zip he puts on the pass. It was interesting the way Keller kind of throws on the brakes to get away from Lindholm, create a little bit of space, and he just hammers it in the back of the net.